One of the ways to fight the fear in the world is to connect. Connect not only to the people around us and the ones we love, I mean that's very important, but to connect to everything. To the city, the government, the world, our enemies, but also to the flowers, the animals, and to every atom that, the way I see it, is here for a reason. Is conscious, maybe on a different level, but is conscious about being here for a reason. Right now, right here, creation, which is what we're living in, the things that came to be, because I believe it's the divine intention to have love and truth in creation and that they have to come together. But I believe that all these connectedness, which holds together, which a physicist would explain to you as energies that resonate, are that love, that connectedness. There would be no material world without connectedness, without vibrations, atoms, electrons, quarks, whatever, relating, connecting, resonating. Now, that resonance is what we have to look for. And in the old days, there was a whole wisdom. You might call it magic, you called it all the Vedantic, the old Vedas. It was the knowledge of connections. And people saw it as a magical knowledge. If you knew the connection between me and the flower, and the name of the flower, and my name, and everything and everything, if you understood the connections, you understood the world. In Sanskrit it was Ya Evam Veda. Three words that say that knowledge and power are connected. That if you have the power you get the knowledge. But it's knowledge about connectedness. It's really knowledge about love. So what do? We have a world that's full of fear. We are afraid of the terrorists, we are afraid of the tax people, we are afraid of you. Always there. So I think we have to look in what psychology and psychiatry and our dear friend Freud and all those people, and maybe using knowledge from long, long before, that knowledge, that understanding about how our psyche works, we have to use that for the psyche of the world. Because this fear that pervades our lives is a collective fear. It's not anymore you and me. It is me against the government, me against the terrorists, me against Islam, me against what? So we have to reconnect. Now, that's an old story, of course. I'm only saying that if we use the techniques that were given to us by the people that developed or discovered psychotherapy and bioenergetics and whatever names they have for all these methodologies to reunite yourself, to get the energy in yourself soft, flexible, loving again. To use that. And there is a lot of knowledge about that. But it's used for individual patients or to help you get through this crisis or that traumatic experience, and we use all kinds of means, and there is technology like LSD that Albert Hofmann discovered that could help you with it. But it's all pushed away as dealing with symptoms in individual cases. I feel the world now needs those therapies, needs those understandings, those wider tools to deal with the fear, to deal with the unconnectedness that creates the fear. And it's simple to say, well, you know, pick up the phone and phone someone or reach out to someone. But I think we have lost that capacity to reach out because of that fear. So we have to very slowly rebuild connectedness communities on a very small scale, starting with the family. Recognize that we've lost the family connection for many people, but beyond the family, your neighbors, your neighborhood, your city, reconnect. And I don't think it's a rational process. I don't think it's a process of rhetorics or political engagement. It's a human engagement. And for me, the way to do that is to look at myself and see how the problems I have when I face fear, fear of rejection, when I meet something that makes me inside stiffen and tighten and get the armor up. The methodologies that I have learned, and they're not very effective all the time, but that they use to release that again and to make it soft, should be used in the world. So we have to start from the real bottom, from our connection to the animistic world, to our connection. Have we lost it? We lost it because we believe it's not rational to talk to trees and to enjoy animals or feel connectedness to even to wood or whatever. And yet, that's what we lost. We lost connectedness. We've lost connectedness in family. We lost connectedness with nature. And we've replaced it by mobile phones. We connect by artificial means and not with people. Our security, do you realize a mobile phone for most people is a security tool? You think you are connected because you can phone the police or your friend or whatever, but it's not really giving you that connectedness. We have tools forever, which are human tools and probably animal tools, to connect with the mind. When you think about a person, when you use that vibration that our brain, our mind, our soul is, and that is connected to everything, suddenly we can connect. We can think about someone and it does reach them. We replace that. We replace that by phone calls, Twittering, Facebooks. Terrible. I would even call them fascist means of replacing our inferiority complex with the superiority of the technology. The iPod is your superior helper. That's real fascism. That is allowing that which is vulnerable and small and lovingly in you and very essential, very easily wounded. That part, to replace that with a machine that looks better and does better and all those things. Let's try to go back to understanding why we use it. I'm not saying don't use a mobile phone. I'm just saying understand what it does to you next to connecting you and make the phone calls and get the cab and all those practical things. It also eats away from our connectedness to ourselves and to the world. Media, those media like iPhones and iPods and all those beautiful things, are extensions of our senses, but they're artificial, and I believe they take away from what we are. They're dangerous. I think children should not be allowed to use all that up to a certain age, and that the telephone and the computer and the internet, apart from having beautiful potential, also has this threat, and we know it. The internet has become big brother for most of us. A digital shadow that has all the information from our past. We cannot get away from it. So slowly, we're becoming afraid of the internet. I've noticed that there is stuff on the internet that I don't want there to be there. That if I want a visa or this and that, everybody, a new job, people look for it. The internet is becoming a power bigger than ourselves, and it feeds the fear because we don't use it the right way. In itself, the internet, tools, mobile phones, they're all fine. But we use them in the wrong way. We use them to grow the fear, to make the fear harder. And as in my body, it leads to hardening parts. It leads to the world becoming harder, stiff, armored, So, fear. Summing it up, fear is what at this moment is all around us, in the world, it's in the media. And I believe that to counteract that fear, to come back to the feeling of communion, the feeling of being together, the feeling of being safe, we have to look at what happens in our own body and use the tools from the psychotherapy, from all the great thinkers and doers and therapists of all times, to find out how we can use that awareness, how our own body works and our own emotions work, to fight this. And then we fight the fear in the world, and then we fight the financial crisis, and then we fight the wars, and hopefully we will be better off.